Hello, welcome back to Dimension Quest. In this week's video, I'll walk you through the steps required to get Ubuntu 2204.1 LTS joined to an Active Directory domain using System Security Services Daemon, also known as SSSD. Now, the domain that I'll be joining it into is the domain that I created in my earlier videos using Zentiol. The same steps that I'm going to do here can be performed in a regular Windows Microsoft Active Directory domain environment. Now, in order to do this, I'll be using a VM that was just created yesterday using my Packer build scripts. The only changes that I've done to the VM after the Packer build completed was changing the wallpaper. So let's go ahead and launch a console from our vSphere. Now we'll go ahead and get logged in with the VMware account. Let me click on there, get logged in. I use VMware because it's simple to type and I do a lot of stuff with vCenter and VMware related things. So when I'm doing testing and building, it's a simple thing to use there. Okay, so here we go. This is a freshly built desktop. As I said, not much has been done post Packer build. We can see that I've got a little script that's running on my login to make sure that my web browsers are up to date. So it's checking for the Microsoft Edge updates. Then it'll check for the Chrome updates, and it'll also check for the Brave browser updates. All right, let me go ahead and open up a terminal here. Okay, so first off, let's make sure that Realm is not installed. Nope, it's not turning green, and if I hit enter, it's not found. And also ADCLI. So I'm just showing that these are not installed yet. So we do have a clean system here where I still need to install the utilities. So in order to get things installed and talking to Active Directory, we will be using this SSSD. And as we can see here, there's some prerequisites here. Now, one of the main things here is that we want to make sure that the domain can be resolved and that the system that we're working on is able to resolve itself. And then we will be installing the tools that are listed here. So SSSD-AD-Tools, Realm-D, and ADCLI. So let's go ahead and get those installed here. But first, let's look at what our host name is. Now the host name is Ubuntu-YT. Now can we ping and resolve by the name? Yes, we can. It's resolving just fine, so we should be good to go there. Now let's go ahead and install the tools that are necessary to join Active Directory. All right, and we'll hit enter. So that should get all the tools installed. Okay, great. Now let's confirm that this VM is now able to at least see and resolve our Active Directory domain. So in order to do that, we're going to do a realm discover. Okay, and we can see that the realm discover for lab.asbl.dev, and again, this is our Zentiol Active Directory domain that we created in the previous videos, is able to get resolved. You can see that we've got our realm name there, we've got our domain name, it is Active Directory, and note here that we are currently not configured. So this means that we have not joined the Active Directory domain yet. And now we'll use the realm command to join the domain. And you'll be prompted for your password. Successfully enrolled machine in Realm. All right, so let's click over to our Zentiol management interface. We'll go into Users and Computers under Manage. And we'll check to see whether or not, yes, we do have it, Ubuntu-YT. And let's go into something that many people may be a little more familiar with, and that's the Active Directory Users and Computers. And if we click on the Computers OU here, the container, we can see, yes, we have Ubuntu-YT. All right, so that indicates that we should be joined to the domain now. So let's click back over to here, and we will close out of... No, we won't close out of things quite yet, because if we take a look back here, we want to make sure that our SSSD configuration is properly filled out. So let's just grab the contents of that. We'll copy that. Now let's pay close attention to the note down here. It does say that the permissions need to be set to 0600 and the ownership should be set to root or the SSSD will not start. So let's make sure we get all that set. Now we're going to change over to our root account. So we'll do a sudo su dash, and we'll change directory into etc SSSD, and we will edit the SSSD.conf file that should have been created. Yes, it was. All right, so let's see here. We've got our lab.asbl.dev up there. Okay, let's make sure everything's set here. Default shell. I don't want that to be bash. I actually want that to be zsh. So I will change that. Okay, store password offline, true. Cache credentials, true. That's the correct realm. ID providers AD, we would definitely want that. Use fully qualified names, true. Okay, everything there's looking pretty good. Let me look at my notes and see if I'm missing anything here. Oh yeah, we can do a case sensitive and set that to false. All right, anything else? So we should be good here. Now we're going to check our service. Active, running, excellent. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just reboot this system. Okay, here's our login screen. And it's defaulting to the previously logged in user, which was VMware. We don't want to do that. We'll click on not listed. And we'll try dev user 1 at our domain name. And the password. Now, the very first time an account logs in, it may take a while for things to get copied over properly, but it looks like we are logged in right away. Okay, this default view is pretty ugly. I really prefer to have the same desktop that my build user had. Now, I've already done a copy of that build user's home directory into the /etc/scale folder, but as we can see, when our new user logged in, that template did not get applied to this user. And the reason for that is because we have not told our configuration files to do that for us. So let's go ahead and do that now. Okay, we'll log back in as our build account, VMware. Okay, and we'll go into our Terminator console here. Change into our super user. Oops, it helps if you type the command correctly. Sudo space su space dash. All right, now go into /etc/pam.d. Now there's several files that are in here. This whole PAM system is modular, and the one that we want in particular here is common-session. So let's edit that one. There we go. So got to scroll down a little bit here. Okay, we can see that we have our authentication here for the PAM SSS. We want to go right after that line there. So we'll go down here, insert, and let's add a new line. And we want to do like this. Session optional PAM underscore MK homedir.so, and we want to tell it where the skeleton files are going to be found. And we'll set a umask on there. Okay, that looks good. So we can see that we get authenticated, we make our home directory, and then we process any mounts and any additional systemd services. So let's close and save. And we will log out of our build account. Just before we go here, let's check our home directory. And by that, I mean the home folder. So currently we only have the VMware account and the Linux brew folder, which is where the brew utilities are installed. So this looks good. Let's go ahead and log out of this account again. And once again, we'll try logging in with a domain account. Okay, let's try that dev user one again. Oops, we need to click the left arrow there and select not listed. Since I only have one domain account, or since I only have one domain tied into this system, I'm able to type just the username without the at lab.asbl.dev. We can see here it's creating the home directory for our account. So this may take a moment. Okay, looking good. Yes, yes, this is what I want to see here. Looks like our background did not come over, but our Conky utility is showing up here. All of our customizations of our dash to panel are showing up. All of our favorite icons are showing there. This is good. Let's go ahead and change our background. I'm not sure why the wallpaper didn't come over. That's okay. Let's see how that looks. Oh, that kind of washes out the purple there. Let's go back to our Waikiki sunset. There we go. Nice. Okay, this is looking good. So we can see here, username is devuser1. Let's open up our Terminator console and take a look at what our home directory looks like now. Okay, we can see that the PAMD make homedir has created our account as our username at the domain that we're a member of. So this is exactly what we want and what we're expecting. Great. Let's take a look at our file manager here real quick. Okay, this is looking good. Let's check other locations. Okay, we can see that we have our shares here. Public shared. And let's go ahead and put in our credentials. Now Now, I'm just going to keep it as remember password until you log out, because my next video, we're going to take care of things so that we can automatically map everything just by logging in. Let's go ahead and connect. There we go. We've got our different folders available here on the public shared. Dev user one. Good. Now, if I try to go into dev user two, yes, we don't have permission. That's perfect. That's what we're expecting here. Okay. Now, if we go to other locations again, now that we're authenticated and we go to that same server, we should see our home directory listed as well. Or not. Interesting. How about if we just go to it directly? There we go. There's our home directory. Okay, so now we're all set. And let's create a new folder there. Testing from Ubuntu YT. All right. Let's click over to our Win 11 Pro. And let's log in as our dev user one. Okay, let's open up our Windows Explorer. And let's look at the network. Let's go ahead and expand that out a little bit there. Here's my dev user one folder, and we can see the folder that was created from the Ubuntu VM. Okay. We are now able to log in from two different operating systems and access our home directory. Oops, yeah, we want to make sure we save that. Okay, now being able to access the console for a VM in vCenter through a web browser, it's okay, but the keys don't carry over quite as nicely as an RDP session, and copy paste doesn't work from inside and outside. So I'm going to close out of this window here. There's our hello from the Windows VM. So let's go ahead and close out here. And we've got 206 there, right? Or 209, what is it? 209. So we're going to do an RDP to this instead. And we'll log out of that. In order to RDP to an Ubuntu VM, you do need to be logged out of the console. Otherwise, your RDP session won't be able to connect. So I have an RDP entry set up over here. There we go. Got our credentials set. So let's try doing the connection. Dev user one. Actually, I think I need to go ahead and specify the domain on my credentials. That way it will pass through the credentials properly through the RDP connection. There we go. Let's try that. That should carry through. Nope, that didn't carry through properly. Oh, I'll get it. Let's cancel that. Because we don't want to have to do a double entry there. Okay, so you can see that when we try to log in using our Active Directory domain user, we're not able to get connected there. Now, there's a little trick to getting that to work. So let's just cancel out of that for right now. And we'll click back in and we'll log in as our build user. Okay, once again, we're going to drop to our command prompt so that we can edit the proper configuration files. And let's go ahead and just bring that full screen, and we will zoom that in a little bit. That's better. All right. Let's change to our super user. And go into our etc SSSD folder, and we want to edit our SSSD conf file. There we go. So what we need to do here is we need to add a couple lines to the end of our file. And it's going to be AD underscore GPO underscore access underscore control equals enforcing. So we want to go ahead and enforce any kind of group policy objects that have been set up for RDP. If we were to set enforcing to permissive, then we could just restart our SSSD service and we would be able to go ahead and get connected. What happens is the group policy would be evaluated but not enforced. So there wouldn't be any prevention of people RDPing to a system that they aren't supposed to be RDP'd to. Now, since we are going to enforce, we need to tell the system how to map the interactive connectivity here. So the next entry that we need is AD underscore GPO underscore map underscore remote underscore interactive equals plus XRDP dash sysman. Okay, we'll save that and we'll do a restart of the service. And let's make sure that the service is actually running and there weren't any errors. Okay, it is running. Okay, so we'll go ahead and log out and we'll try logging in via RDP using an Active Directory domain account again. Let's try doing our RDP session again. That's already looking better. Okay, wow. Beautiful. Look at that. Now, let's see if our sound is working. A lot of people have trouble with sound with RDP. It most certainly is. Now, I have noticed that RDP does not carry very seamless sound or video over it, which is fine. My purposes of using RDP over to an Ubuntu VM is to do Kubernetes development, scripting development, that kind of stuff where it's a lot of console base and just working in an Ubuntu environment with a graphical user interface. If I want to browse websites, listen to music, watch videos, I do that on my local system, not via RDP. But we do have the ability to do RDP. There is sound there for at least the system sounds, so we are all set. Okay, I think I've met all my goals for this video. I've gotten an Ubuntu 2204.1 Jammy Jellyfish VM joined to my Active Directory domain. I've got RDP working. I've confirmed that the access to network shares is available. In my next video, I'll focus on automatically mapping folders to shares on our Active Directory server. Thanks and take care.